Isn't it great when you find a new gadget that just makes your working day easier? And if it doesn't cost a fortune, it can really make you smile. I'm using a new one now. Have you guessed what it is?
Ta-da!
It's a small single-channel audio recorder, the Zoom F1. Now, I know I did a video earlier about the Zoom F4, the four-channel audio mixer, and I still think that's probably the ideal mixer for a cameraman who has to work on his own without a sound recordist. But there's lots of times when even carrying a mixer around is too much. One solution is just use a radio mic and link straight back to the camera. But I'm really not a fan of radio mics. They always go wrong at the worst possible moment. It doesn't matter what you do. You can pray to your gods and sacrifice a chicken. If they just don't want to work, they won't. So I'm actually quite a fan of these RodeLink filmmaker kits, I think they call them. They work on Wi-Fi frequencies and they just seem a bit more bomb-proof. They work for idiots, even when there's lots of RF radio mics around and lots of real sound engineers operating them. Trouble is, it's becoming quite normal for us to have to use lots of different cameras every single day. You might have something on a gimbal or even a drone, and you don't want to be carrying one of these on a drone. So my new solution is the little F1 from Zoom, and it looks really neat and chunky at the same time. This one comes with a lavalier mic, but you can get a version that comes with a shotgun attachment that clips on the top. It's got a very bright and clear LCD screen that makes setting this up very easy, even in bright daylight. As well as all the flavours of MP3 recording, this will also record WAV files, 24-bit WAV files at 96 kHz, and that's good. There are two sockets on the bottom, way too small for XLRs unfortunately, so it's 3.5mm only, but you've got a mic input which you can also pump line level into as well, and a headphone output. Now you can use this for monitoring the quality of whatever you're setting up. But the other thing you can use it for is you could loop through to a radio mic. The big disadvantage with using a little recorder like this rather than a radio mic is you can't monitor for problems in real time. You just have to record it and hope it's all working okay. If that's a real problem for you, you could loop through to a radio mic and still have the advantages of local recording. Something strange about the design of this is it looks like the sockets for the microphone and the headphone are on the bottom. But there's a belt clip comes with this, and it's clear from the design that it's meant to be operated that way up, upside down. But when it's on your belt, it'll look the right way up when you look at it. And that's a giveaway. What that says to me is it's designed to be used by the person who's wearing it and not a sound engineer. As well as the option of putting a shotgun mic on the front, these bars at the back are designed to sit in a shock mount, and you could put the whole thing on top of a DSLR. I do wish that you could take these little bars off so that when you were using it in somebody's pocket, it would be a little bit smaller. As well as the micro SD card slot, there's also a USB interface that you can download files from it, but also you can use it as a digital interface for your audio. There's also a couple of buttons for headphone volume and one for locking the buttons so you don't inadvertently turn it off when it's in your pocket. Very useful. On the front, there's four little buttons that change the record format. There's a low cut for taking out some of the rumble, a limiter button, and a button for record level. And that's basically it. It does exactly what it says on the box. You plug a microphone in the bottom, hit record, and it sounds really good. I've been using this for a few days now, and on average, I'm getting about 10 hours worth of use, constant use, from two AAA batteries. And that's really good as well. But there are a couple of issues. Like I said before, I wish you could take these bars off the back and make the whole thing smaller when you need to put it in somebody's pocket. More importantly, the record level isn't linear, it's stepped. So you go from low, medium, high, high plus, or auto. Don't use it in auto, way too much noise. And it's okay, but it doesn't give you fine control. But then you're not monitoring this anyway, so why do you need fine control? The other thing about these bars is they get in the way of things like the cover for the SD card slot. You can't get your fingers in. I've got fat sausage fingers, so I can't get them in to get the card out. Same problem with the batteries, AA batteries, but the battery cover is a little bit flimsy and a little bit, it's very easy to pop that off inadvertently, especially if you're pulling it out of somebody's pocket. You'll quite often unlatch the battery and then you've lost your recording. So it's probably going to have a bit of gaffer tape on it very soon. Does that sound any better to you? I found a COS 11D professional microphone and I was able to put a 3.5mm jack on the end of it, plug it straight in, it powers it, and I wondered if it was any better. Does it sound any better? I think the Zoom lavalier mic that comes with this sounds pretty good. They've been out a little while now, so I was able to get this one with the mic for £140, and that is an amazing value for something of this quality. So in conclusion, even allowing for the little design issues, I really like this. It's not going to be a recorder I use all the time. It's not going to be a recorder that replaces radio mics, but it's just another tool that makes things easier. So the next time you get the drone or the crane or the gimbal out, this gives you another option and it's great value. You just might have to cover it in gaffer tape to stop the presenters playing with it. And if we're talking about things to make your day go easier, I'm a big fan of these Rycote stickies. Little sticky pads, you can put them on clothing, the mic sticks to the pad, and then the fluffy sticks on top of everything, and you're sorted. Just make your life easy. If you found any gadgets or tricks that make your working day go easier, do let me know in the comments below, and we'll share them with everyone. And if you like and subscribe, hopefully there'll be more. Sounds good.